Hello everybody, this is Jen from Garden Jen's Journey. I'm going to give you a tour today of the homestead. I see a lot of people do that and I figured I'd do it too just so you can see what's going on. Right now we're looking at an apple tree that we kind of dug out last year. Actually it was connected to a different apple tree and you can kind of see the trunk there. I'll walk in a little bit. My shadow's really casting right now. But there's a trunk of another apple tree that was standing here, and years ago it was hit by lightning and completely killed that tree. So when my husband moved here, we saw this baby apple tree growing out from underneath the charred stump. So we cut what was left of the trunk of the old apple tree out to give this guy room to grow. And it's gotten quite big. Last year it had it had no fruit on it yet, but this year we're going to try to give it some natural fertilizer and give it some antifungal properties, because we did have some black spots and stuff on it, and see if we can get it really healthy this year and see if we can get it to produce at least some buds. Not too worried about fruit exactly, since it is a young tree, but just seeing how healthy we can get this baby after the hard life it's been through already. Over there are some cows. They actually belong to our landlords who live across the way. And those cows actually come across here during different times of the year. And there's a pasture that actually runs around our home in a horseshoe shape. I try not to get the sun glare. And anyways, so we deal with them. And it's kind of neat having them over here. We have some that just like to stare at you and see what you're doing and things of that sort. And then the bull, of course, is funny to watch as well. So we definitely live in the country. We live on a dead-end road. It actually dead-ends on state land, so we can go down on state land and walk trails and things with our dogs. So it's kind of nice. And all the people down this road are farmers, except for the very last house. They're not exactly farmers, but they live way down there and nice people. Anyway, this guy right here, this is a lilac that I had planted 2 years ago in the fall. As you can see, my fence here isn't very good. It got basically blasted by the plow trucks that come through here. The county plow trucks just really hammer things. Fence posts and mailboxes and things kind of get blown away by the snow that hits them. But anyways, I have a lilac bush in there. Then I have a quince plant here. And this was given to me by a friend of ours. And I planted it here and it's doing really well. I did have it in my garden originally, but because the quince can get to a nice sized plant, it's a large bush. I got it out of my garden after it had developed a good root system and brought it out here. And it's doing really well so far. And then this is another old wild apple tree. We actually pruned it a little bit last year, kind of got some of the dead stuff off it. Well, wild apple trees are generally not messed around with much. People just leave them alone, but we figured since we're here, we'll take care of it to the best of our ability and help it thrive better. Now here's an old camper trailer, pop-up trailer, plus my dearest mouser friend, Sarah. She came with the house. It's kind of funny. But anyways, this camper trailer was given to us. It's an interesting camper trailer because it actually has a front compartment for storage, which is going to be great. This camper trailer is actually going to be turned into a chicken coop. It's a hard top trailer. And what's going to be done is my husband's going to take out all the canvas and all the webbing and everything that you see there. And then around the main compartment here, basically between the upright supports and around the front there, not where the bed extends out, but just directly across, he's going to box this in with some plywood that he got. And so it'll be a fully enclosed structure for chickens. So we're recycling that. We do a lot of recycling here. That's why it looks like we have a lot of junk laying around, because it's actually recycled. And with it being the winter, we don't have the weather to actually build stuff. So actually our junk pile is just stockpiled items for building in the spring and summer of the following year. Like this OSB that my husband got from a work site, They were just throwing it out because they had too much of it and they were getting rid of it. OSB is not cheap. I mean, you're looking at 15, 20 bucks a sheet here. And well, you can see how many sheets we got laying here. This will actually be used to build a woodshed this spring. We had problems with our wood that we got getting wet this year. The tarps didn't cover it. So since my husband had a free supply of OSB, and we also have some 2x4s and things like that that we got that recycled for free, he's going to build a woodshed. So praise the Lord for that. He provides for us. And this is this side of the camper trailer, and it's got two doors, which makes it awesome. My husband's actually going to cut a hole in the bottom of the inner door there, the plastic part of the bottom, so the chickens can come in and out. And the outside door here, we can leave it open when we want the chickens in and out most of the time. Or if there's a situation where we need to lock the chickens in the coop or out of the coop, we can close that outer door there and they'll be locked either in or out. So it's kind of cool as a bonus. This trailer here, my husband made from another pop-up camper. It was kind of like this one, but smaller. But he junked that out, he cleaned it all out, recycled what he could. And then he built it for his mowing and things like that, because my husband runs a landscaping business as well as some other things. So he completely built this by hand. And then back here is my son's tinker project number one. He calls this the Busted Hotness. And if any of you watch MIB, Men in Black, you know what that refers to. But anyways, it's an old truck and we have it running now. But the wood that you see stacked there is actually going to be the brand new bed for the truck. The bed is completely rusted out. So the wood will be cut down and pieced together, and they're going to build a flat bed for the truck there. So that's why that's all there. Another lilac bush here. Another project for my son here is a very old trailer. This thing's older, or not trailer, snowmobile. This thing's actually older than I am. It's another tinker project for my son. It doesn't need much work, but it does need some to get it up and running. So hopefully by next year, this will be ready to blaze down those trails out back. I'm going to try to take my time here. All this water that we had this week just froze overnight because it got really cold. Okay, here's another donation here. It's a long trailer that we got from somebody. It was also another camper trailer, one of those big RV kind of things, fifth wheel kind of things, except it's not a fifth wheel, it's a regular hitch. But anyways, that's what this is, and right now it looks like a big junk heap, but it's actually containing all of our scrap wood that we need to burn in the wood stove for an emergency. We were running low on regular wood, so we had this scrap wood here. It's a bunch of barn wood and some things that was rotten and things like that. So still not quite sure what we're going to do with this year. Our intent is to make it a large large box trailer that we can haul debris and things in for the landscaping business, or some larger pieces of equipment. If we borrow a tractor or something, we can haul it on this. It's big enough. So anyways, that's what this junk pile is here. And then this is another win. Again, we're big into recycling. This is the wood that's actually going to be used for the chicken coop that I had just showed you. These are actually shipping crates, deconstructed shipping crates, from a project that my husband worked on. And it's amazing how wasteful America is. There's nothing wrong with these boards. I'm trying to get around this wood here. This wood was also just donated by somebody, so we have a bunch more wood to burn in our wood stove. Anyways, it's just amazing how wasteful we are as a country. This wood here, there's nothing wrong with it at all. It's just served its purpose. So then it was going to be just thrown away. And there's nothing absolutely wrong with this wood. I mean, it's regular plywood. I think half inch plywood. And then you've got some 1x4s. Beautiful, beautiful pieces of wood. But anyways, they're just going to throw it away because it had done its purpose. They were shipping crates. So my husband said, oh no, you ain't throwing that away. I'll take it off your hands. Save yourself the dumpster fee, and well, it's going to save us a lot of money because this is free wood that we're going to repurpose. So it's just amazing on how wasteful America is, that they'll just throw good wood like this away instead of recycling it. So we're going to recycle it. And then go back over here. Same with this brush. We're going to be getting a chipper this year because we put wood chips in our garden. And so this brush here and any brush that we get from our landscaping jobs, we can recycle it. We were just burning it before because we didn't have access to a wood chipper. But now that we have access to get a wood chipper, we're stockpiling it. And then once we get the chipper, this will all be chipped down and it'll be put into our garden over here. In this garden, you can see also another couple things that are recycled. These are pallets that I'm using for my fence. And these are going to be for vertical gardening. I'll be able to grow some things up them, like climbing roses, peas, and things like that that actually climb. They can climb on my fence. I've recycled it. We do have some things that we have bought, like these cattle panels here. This is a cattle panel that's used as an arch that gets used as a trellis too. And then also have some tires. And I did a lot of research before I decided to recycle these. But tires actually can be recycled. They're not toxic to the environment as long as they are whole. The problem with tires is when they start, if they get tears or when we chop them up like people use them for playground mulch and stuff like that, that's when the tires start to become toxic to the environment. But in this current state that they are, these tires will last for 30, 40 years and not be a problem. So I'm actually going to be growing things in these tires. And then this as well down here, these guys, I got really, really cheap. We go to a place that makes fencing. And these are actually rejects from fence posts. They make fence posts, and if they're not straight or if they're really tapered a lot, like the one over here in the corner here, it's tapered too much. It's not a good steady shape. They're rejects, so they stockpile them out back and they sell them for pennies on the dollar just to make some profit off of their waste. And the same thing with the mulch that they sell. Their mulch from the company is a byproduct of making fence posts. So again, they're making money off their waste product, which is good. You know, they're making something out of nothing. Same here. These are railroad ties that I recycled from a friend, and this actually lines a potato bed. It's where I grow my potatoes, and I grow them very easily. I just throw potatoes in, space them apart a little bit, and then just cover them with straw. That's it. I don't need to plant them into, you know, dirt or anything. I just put them on top, cover them with straw, and let them go, and I get very good harvest from doing it this way. So again, these are recycled railroad ties, and you can see they're quite rotten, but they're serving their purpose. They're just outlining the bed, containing the straw, and things of that sort. Another recycled item is over here. I've asked for a lot of help with this because we generally don't drink water or milk jugs or juice or anything like this. So this is winter sown plants. These are seeds that have been planted in dirt in milk jugs, and then they sit out here they sit out here, and then when it warms up and the rest of nature is starting to bloom and bud out and start to grow, the seeds in these milk jugs will do the same, and the seedlings will actually be hardened instead of if you're growing them indoors. Like a lot of people grow their vegetable seedlings and stuff indoors and then bring them outside. These are already outside, so it saves on trying to have to get them hardened so they'll last out here. And then this is my garden space. It's 70 by 30 right now. It's a good size space, and I have it planned out. I kind of do, or I'm doing, I should say, I haven't done it yet. I'm doing the square foot gardening method somewhat in here so I can get the most bang for my space, because we want to grow a lot of food here, not just for my family, but to be able to help the community as well. So we want to make sure that we squeeze as many plants in here as we can. That'll be efficient. We don't want to overcrowd, but we want to make sure that we're planting in a way that is using our asset here, our land here, the best way possible. And this is the way, this was the first entrance that we had made for the garden. The other entrance that we came through didn't exist until last year, when I decided I was tired of climbing over the railroad ties that we originally had out there. So this was our first gate. It's a cano paddle again, and we used it for a trellis for, I had squash on this side, and then over on this side I had peas and beans. And it did really good. They grew really well. This is our chicken coop. It was made out of recycled materials. And right now this one has 8 chickens. When my husband gets done with the other one and gets it placed, it'll have 15 chickens. And we're also thinking about getting some ducks maybe, or some turkeys. We're not quite sure yet. But anyways, everything that we have here has been built out of recycled materials. So, you know, it doesn't look all pretty and fancy like some people who buy all brand new materials and fancy kits or whatnot. But for us, this is what it's all about, recycling the waste that other people throw out into something that can sustain our family. And so it works really well. And over here, it looks like a junk pile, and a lot of it is. This was that area that a lot of junk was kept in, and because it's a back away from the road and stuff. And we will be getting rid of most of this stuff in the spring when it warms up. We'll be making a trash run to get rid of some of these items. And then I'm actually going to have elderberry bushes planted back here, so this will fill in against the back of the garage, and it'll look really nice once we get it cleaned up. But we do have some things that we're recycling here, like the steel roof there. My husband saved again. Wasteful America. This was from another building or something, and they were just going to chuck it because they had no use for it. My husband's like, no, I will take that from you. Not a problem. This steel roof is actually what's going to go here. We're going to actually rebuild the coop a little bit, and then the roof will go there. Right now I have a couple pieces of plywood up. So again, we're taking somebody else's trash and making it into our treasure. Our chickens are a little angry today. They get bored, and so they start getting a little antsy. All right, our last item on our recycling list here are these puppies. These are regular pallets, and these are untreated pallets, so they haven't been sprayed with chemicals or anything. These, again, you saw, I used them for my fencing and things like that. So, anyways, this is my homestead. This is how we recycle things and make things work. Back here is the drainage field, so we really haven't done too much with it, but we have major plans for it this year because of the kind of environment we're in. The drainage field has a hard time draining right now, so we've got plans to help it out naturally to make it more efficient, and we'll see how that goes. So anyways, this is Jen. This is my homestead. I hope that you're having a blessed day. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye now.